Overwhelm. That's another buzzword that I hear these days. Friends, family, colleagues, everyone uses it. And it's not just the prerogative of the corporate types. Stay-at-home moms and pops, out-of-work artists, house help, and even small babies feel overwhelmed. Do you know, overwhelm is just a kind of fear. It's a worry that we'll not be able to get everything done. So that's exactly what we are going to look at today. We'll identify the fears that cause overwhelm and look at easy steps to get over overwhelm. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere. Light on! Your mind is based in fear. And it does what it always does, which is push that fear back onto you. When something happens, the mind goes, oh my God, what if this happens? What if that happens? First, you need a primer. Just like how you would paint your house, your furniture, or even your face, you first need to put a coat of primer. So I'll give you four words which you can use as a primer. Tell your mind, thank you for sharing. Four words. Thank you for sharing. Every time a fear comes up, every time a doubt comes up, just say, thank you for sharing. Next, you need to speak to your mind and set the story right. Now, your mind is your bodyguard. It's your guardian angel. You don't tell your bodyguard, shut up, do you? You have to just give it assurance. So first, you tell your mind, thank you for sharing, and then give it assurance. Much like you would assure a small child. Now, this is the method. You assure your mind, calm it down, and breathe deeply, come back to the present. Now, I don't want you to just kinda do it. I want you to do exactly this, and it will improve your life almost instantaneously. Now, what do you think is going to happen? The first time you do it, your mind is going to say, yeah, right. And it's going to do that over and over again. I want you to do only one thing. Just keep reassuring your mind. Keep saying it's all okay. This works only if there is practice. So all you have to do is practice, practice, practice. Do you know what the good news is? Your mind will keep bugging you over and over again. So you will get lots of practice. Your mind is the best practice partner that you can ever ask for. All you have to do is just go through it. Practice, practice, practice. You're going to get lots of practice, don't worry. Don't converse with your mind and allow it to mind freak you. Take control of your mind. Give it easy commands. Keep it short, keep it simple. Much like how you would, let's say, talk to a dog or even a child. Whoops, did I just put a dog and a baby in the same category? I'm sure all parents will understand. What do you do when a child comes to you having fallen and crying? Do you say, oh my God, what happened to you? Look at all the blood. It'll just scare the child all the more and make him even more upset. What do we do as parents? We just pick up the child, dust him, clean him, kiss the boo-boo and say, okay now, it's all fine. And sure enough, he's happy and running in the next second. That's all you have to do with your mind. So what do I have in my toolbox for you today? Let's delve in. I want to start this toolbox with a PJ. How do you eat a pizza? One bite at a time. How do you eat a large pizza? One bite at a time. Overwhelm happens when we have too much to do or we take on a project which is so big that we get paralyzed by fear. So break it down, prioritize, and do it one step at a time. And if you feel overwhelmed, remember the four-word mantra. Thank you for sharing. Try this method and let me know. I'd love to hear from you. So that's it for this week. Watch out for more life hacks in our next videos. You can always go back to the blog and feel free to send us your queries, your doubts, and any comments. We accept compliments too. We'll tell you thank you for sharing. To spread the light, you know what you have to do. Like, share, and subscribe.